Okay, so good afternoon. It looks I am the oldest representative of startup changing the idea that the startup founders have to be young people. Well, I can say that my story started 30 years ago when I was graduated student. Beginning of 90s, unfortunately, had no savings, no ID. So the thing was that I started academic career, and when I received the highest position in academic professorship, I was looking how to continue. And well, I had some savings, so and I got an ID, so I said, let's build a startup. Things about environmental aspects, population aspects of insect were already mentioned by Teras, so I will skip it. And probably just to tell you why we decided for mealworms, because you heard already about crickets. Mealworms are the traditional insect here in European diet. Since we are using grain, we eat mealworms. Any idea how many insects, how many grams of insects you eat every year, unexpectedly, unfittingly? There is such like eating cherries, bread, which contains for sure about 1 kilo. So already, even don't know, the European, average European leads, eat almost 1 kilo of insects a year. Sure, Asia and those countries traditionally, they eat it in a form like that you see the insect. Here, the Europeans are afraid of seeing insects, so the idea was that we have to process insects to some form which is invisible and just use the argument that you have those people who like to switch from meat to something else. Surveys even tell, which surprised me a lot when I read it first time, that even 50% of vegetarians and vegans accept insects as an alternative to meat protein. So the market is big. What we started, well, the idea was to provide immediately what we call nanopate to producers of food, which like to bring the new product containing the protein, because there is a European legislative called novel food, which allowed to use insect protein in the food. Unfortunately, you know, regulations in Europe are heavy, so it will last several years to fight with the legal obstacles. So what we did started, the simple thing, we said, okay, we can dry the mealworms and to sell them to pet stores, to feed wild birds, turtles, fox, anything which you can use dried insects. So that's one of our market. The second one, you can offer some grounded types to producers of pet food for cats, dogs, but again, it takes quite a long time because when we deliver them the sample, they normally require 100 kilo. Then they have to produce the granules, and then they hear veterinary testing it. So again, it's run for a long distance. And the final thing is the potential to produce the to replace the traditional sources of protein for if you produce eggs, broilers, and those or fishies artificially. So recently we have three type of revenues. First, selling the dried mealworms. Second, selling the processed mealworms to those who are producing the pet food. And the third one is the project Toucher testing the mealworms for broilers and hens. And still, we have our main product, which is the nanopate pasta. Unfortunately, we even negotiated with companies like Emco, which were not willing to accept it because allergens. So we decided, and we like to use the price to come with our own product. And my final objective, because I'm old enough, there is an empty space on Times Square for advertisement. So I like to have at the end the advertisement King of the Worms at the Times Square. Thank you for your attention.